Thanks for joining me for project two in this series on the Howard Roberts Superchops method. Well, here in this installment, I will be getting into far greater detail regarding what you can play over the exercises found in your handout from the first video of this series. Now, several viewers wrote in after the first video hit YouTube asking me for more detail about how to practice the Superchops method using the handout sheet included from Project 1. So what I decided to do is redesign that handout altogether. The new handout contains far greater detail regarding what types of scales and arpeggios that you can use. Now, let's get down to business here. In this video, I'd like to spend time discussing specifically what kinds of scales, arpeggios, and substitutions you can use over the chord progressions found in the handout. So let's zoom in on the fingerboard and go through the Superchops Project 1 exercises in far greater detail. On Superchops Jam number 1, we have a D major 7 chord. And you could begin by just playing D major scale. The next pass, you could try doing D Lydian. Just have to be aware of that fourth degree that changes. Also, you try D major pentatonic. A major pentatonic is another really nice sound for that. For the Lydian sounds, you could try E major pentatonic. Some nice sounds there. For arpeggios, of course, there's D major 7 arpeggio. You could do B minor 7, the relative minor sound. You could also go for the major 3rd. Diatonic substitute off that, so it puts you at F sharp and you play the minor 7. You could even try adding the 9th to some of these, and you could do D major 7 arpeggio, but add the 9th in it. You could do the same thing with the B really as well, you know. Major 7th against chord for that, B minor. If you wanted some Lydian sounds, you could go off of A major 7. Go back a semitone and play off of the C sharp minor 7. The 5th of the C sharp minor 7 chord becomes that raised 4th. For the E dominant 7th arpeggio, it's probably one of my favorite, or the dominant 7th arpeggio from a whole step up, I should say, E7 in our case. Great sound. And you can add the 9th to some of these as well. It sounds great on the E. You can even add the 9th on that A major 7 arpeggio. The 9th to the F sharp minor, but lots to do on just the D major 7. You have several passes on that one. In Superchops Jam number 2, we've got an E major 7 chord going over to an E minor 7 chord. On the first pass for that E major 7, I think I'd just take some E major scale. Maybe on a subsequent pass, you could do some Lydian mode. Could do some B major pentatonic. You go to 5th of your major 7 chords and play a pentatonic. Got a pretty cool sound. Major pentatonic would be nice. When we move to the E minor 7, you could do E Dorian. And some cool pentatonics might be going back a whole step playing a major pentatonic. In our case there, we would put it on D. Also do the G major pentatonic or the E minor pentatonic. That's pretty straightforward though. Another choice you could try and mess around with is A major pentatonic. Okay. That's for the minor. So those are some scale choices for you. On the world of arpeggios, could obviously start with the arpeggio off the root, so E major 7 arpeggio. And you could do some diatonic subs on that, maybe G sharp minor. Or C sharp minor. For for the world of E minor 7 chord, you could of course go off the root of that one as well. You could also do G major 7 on top of that. That's a nice way to get a ninth against that E minor 7 sound. B minor 7 arpeggio is pretty cool too. So on the E minor 7 chord, go to the fifth there. Another nice one is to go back a whole step and play the major 7 arpeggio on that chord. So we could go into D major 7 arpeggio. So lots of pretty cool choices of scales and arpeggios that you can work on for the jam number 2. On Superchops jam number 3, we have a 2-5-1 progression where we're going E minor 7 to A dominant 7th and then D major 7. So if you wanted to stay pretty basic in the beginning, you could just play all D major scale for all four bars. That would work fine. If you want to get a little bit adventurous, you could try E Dorian on the E minor 7 chord. For the A 7th, you could even try going outside a little bit and playing some altered scale, you just basically B flat melodic minor. Some pretty cool sounds that way. Also, another cool effect can be had by going up a fourth on those dominant chords and playing harmonic minor. That would put us off of D. Some nice sounds that way too. For pentatonics, you could go up a fourth, play D major pentatonic. And then, of course, A major pentatonic. That's a nice sound, pretty congruent sound. For your D major 7 chord, if you wanted to, you could just keep playing A major pentatonic. That's a really nice sound. We talked about that already a few times there, going up a fifth on your major 7 and playing a major pentatonic. So that's going to be a nice sound, too. For the world of arpeggios, you could just go off of the root of each chord, so E minor 7 for the E minor 7, A dominant 7th for that chord, and then D major 7 for that chord. You could also just do the diatonic subs, so keep it really simple. You could do a pass where maybe for the E minor 7 you could do G major 7 arpeggio. That's going to be a nice sound, adding in that ninth. For the A dominant 7th, you can do one of my favorites there, the C sharp minor 7 flat 5. Off of your dominant 7th chords, if you want to make influence of dominant 9th, you can go to the 3rd of the chord and play minor 7 flat 5 arpeggio. Great choice on that one. On the D major 7, just go to the 3rd, play F sharp. Sounds out of the F sharp minor 7 arpeggio there. Or triad, you could do triad. Okay. So lots of cool choices for that progression as well. So as you can tell, it wouldn't be too hard to blow an entire hour practicing over just these three chord progressions. There's so much that you can play on every exercise. But keeping in mind, within the Superchops philosophy, what you'll want to do is restrict yourself to just 15 minutes per Superchops jam and give yourself about a 3 to 5 minute break in between so you can clear your mind and start into each new exercise with a fresh perspective. And by all means, feel free to design your own Superchops exercises as well. In fact, in the next video of this series, I'll be discussing that very thing for you. So just a heads up, in Project 3, we will create a group of new studies and I'll go through some good tips for you on how you can write your own Superchops exercises as well. Anyway, best of luck with your Superchops practice. You can get the free handout and a couple of MP3 jam tracks for this Superchops project over at my website at andrewwasson.com. That's about all for now. Thanks for watching, and the links are all in the description box below. Take care, everybody, and I'll catch up with you next time. Bye for now.